G'day to yours. Well, it's a good thing I'm back up like a bastard. This thing went from having 26 bad sectors to 630 bad sectors within 2 seconds for no apparent reason. So, geez, for only 60 something days of use, it's not good. Especially for something made in China. Bad sector debuggery. Its health didn't go down by much though. Its health's only 39%, down from 50. I wonder if I can get some really, really, really powerful magnets. Put one here, and put one here. And as a drive spins, it'll wipe and realign the magnetic media. I wonder if that'll fix bad sectors if it's magnetically done. It's a shame it's got bad sectors though. I do like the flatness, quietness of this drive. Definitely Maxtor's design this. It's a shame. I did like that nice flat profile though. This hasn't gotten much worse. It's got 64 bad sectors now and 130 pending sectors, which has actually gone down from 180 pending sectors. But it hasn't actually the bad sectors aren't getting real, haven't done much on this compared to this drive. So yeah. Back up, back up, back up. I suggest back up. As I said, you can never have too many hard drives. Really solid drive of WD green, but yeah, I prefer the reds or the blacks and WDs. Anyway, let's get back to the meters. Okay, we extended the roof on this too on the other day because it was too short here and it was water getting in here. Luckily, that's been taken care of. Everything else, okay, for last night's rain. Now, this meter has the other font type that I've been searching for ages. This looks more more natural, like it's hand drawn, so to speak. We are for this font of the number wheel for a while. So there's emails of that on there as well. The email Mark One's had this on there as well. This exact actual readout itself. I'm just getting nothing but dial pointer ones flat out. Oh my god. Haven't got one psychonumeric like this one email yet. In that style. That old style. Wayne Beanbox Deluxe keeps asking me, any of these rate changes? Well, I don't think any of them actually are. Most of them are just regular time switches. And this one, on off, on off, on off. Yeah, no rate, doesn't have rates on there. I think my ASTRO one, that really rare ASTRO one I've got for the street lighting, that one there is probably the only rate one I've got, I think. Just got several wheels on it, or ripple, well, no ripple ones, eh? But it doesn't have any ripple or anything. I've got to determine if I'll for that one. I think Raymond from 2007 has cut one of these. A couple of these ones. This one has a terminal cover. But the other one that I got last time doesn't have a terminal cover. I've got to find it. No, I think I have got one that may fit it, but if I don't, I'm going to be screaming. Anyway, let's get on to testing this device here. I've also, I've got myself a smart pen for fixing car scratches and car paint, and I'm going to just go fill that cut up in that glass, and that'll clean that cut up real nicely. Anyway, let's get on to testing this device, shall we? Come on, device is energized, ready for a test. Let's get that load wheel in motion. Alright. Where we are, 10 to 60 amps. Halfway between that one, so it'll be halfway between a 7, 8 and a 9, I mean. This is definitely a whole colour. Colour chart sober one, so I've got to give the variac just a slight turn, but I'm going to put barely anything into that MOT to load up a current transformer base meter directly. You don't want to put too much, otherwise you burn it out. If I want to fully load it, I've got to go get my current transformers out of storage. That's halfway through, and that's almost there. That was 1, 2, 300 watt hours. And that's gone 300 watt hours. Look at that, neck and neck. Neck and neck. It's interesting, because this one rotates this way. The numbers go down, on the Iskra they go, yeah, up. Yeah, the Iskra wheels go up, and these wheels go down. Gearing's different on different meters. I do like this style of font though. It looks almost like it's painted on by hand. Like the slight imperfections. It doesn't look like it's perfectly printed by a computer or anything. Really cool. Halfway through exactly. Almost there. Oh, beautiful. That's halfway through now. That one is straightened up on a dot. 60,538 on a dot. This is halfway, 25,162. Halfway, neck and neck. BEAUTYFUL, as high one voltage one rules would say. Look at that, eh? Winner, winner, chicken dinner. 3558. There's no property of detail markings in this one. As you can see, it has a black dunkiness around it. Very sticky, messy stuff. I have to go around it with a razor blade around the edge to clean that off. A lot of them, they didn't do that. Nice and straight load wheel. Nice. Look at that, eh? Beautiful. It should be halfway, and it's almost there. 1, 2. Yep. Almost there. Again, this will always advance a tiny bit more because it's going to measure the potential coil to this meter. Look at the Iskra go, the buggery. It's like a hard drive. I can stick some heads in there, record some data when that load wheel is spinning that fast. Oh yes. Neck, it's perfect. It's absolutely perfect. Beautiful. Zero it off. It's accurate. Winner, winner, chicken dinner. Links. It's unplugged safety first, by the way. Always unplug safety first before you go touching things like this. Yeah, they're in series, so they're not going to get as hot. So they've been, the current's been split between those wires. All right, it's time for a clean. Alright, this device is nice and cleaned. Give it a bit of a buff with a scourer. I could do a cut and polish in it when I want to shine it up, but for now, I got the paint off the front of it. You can see that. Good gear train. Good Australian quality. I remember the ads on TV, Australian made, global quality. There we are. Nice and cleaned up. Specs again. Thanks for watching.